Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the last video, we have discussed about the DC offset errors in the op-amp, and we have seen that usually the op-amp manufacturers used to provide the three parameters related to these DC offset errors. And out of the three parameters, we have already discussed about the input offset voltage. So now in this video, let us understand about the input offset current and the input bias current, and let us see how these currents can affect the output of the op-amp and how we can reduce the effect of these bias currents. So now, so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the op-amp is an ideal op-amp. That means the no current is flowing into the op-amp terminals. But actually, if you see, whenever the biasing voltages are applied to the op-amp, at that time, the small amount of current used to flow through these input terminals. And these currents are known as the input bias currents. So let us say the current that is flowing through this non-inverting terminal is a IB plus, and the current that is flowing through this inverting terminal is a IB minus. So if you see the internal structure of this op-amp, then these currents are basically the currents which are flowing through this transistor of the differential amplifier. So if this op-amp is constructed using the bipolar transistors, then these biasing currents are basically the base current of this transistor. And if op-amp is designed using the MOSFETs or JFET, in that case, these biasing currents are the gate current of these transistors. Now, the direction of these biasing currents depends upon the type of transistors which are used in development of this op-amp. For example, if this differential amplifier is designed using the NPN transistors, in that case, these biasing currents are entering into the op-amp. While in case of PNP transistors, these biasing currents are going in the outward direction. Now, usually in the data sheets, this input bias current is defined as the average value of these two currents. So we can say that the input bias current is the average value of this current IB plus and the IB minus. So that is the definition of the input bias current. Now, ideally, these two biasing currents should be identical, but because of some mismatch between the two transistors, there will be some difference between the two biasing currents, and the difference between the two input bias currents is usually defined as the input offset current in the data sheets. So this input offset current is the difference between the two biasing currents. Now this input offset current can be either positive or negative, but in data sheets, this input offset current is defined by an absolute value. Now for the general purpose op-amps, the value of this input bias current used to be in the range of nanoamperes. But it can be as high as microamperes for very high speed op-amps, or it can be as low as femtoamperes for very precise amplifiers. For example, if you take the case of LT6273, which is a very high speed op-amp, for that case, the value of this input bias current used to be in the range of microamperes. While if you take the case of general purpose op-amp like LM741, in which the input bias current used to be in the range of nanoampere. While if you see the high precision op-amps like AD549, in that case, the input bias current used to be in the range of femtoamperes. So as you can see over here, the typical value of this input bias current is very small. And because of that, for most of the applications, the effect of this input bias current will be negligible. But for the applications where you require very precise output, in that case, this bias current will become a critical parameter. So now let us see the effect of these input bias currents on the feedback circuits. So here we have an inverting op-amp circuit, and for this configuration, let us see how the input bias currents will produce a small amount of error in the output voltage. So now to find the effect of this input bias current, let us assume that all the inputs which are applied to these op-amp circuits are zero. So we can consider this voltage Vin as a 0 volt. And the equivalent circuit will look like this. Now here we are assuming that the input bias current IB minus is flowing in the inverting terminal, and the input bias current IB plus is flowing into the non-inverting terminal. So now if you observe over here, this non-inverting terminal is at a ground potential. So there will not be an effect of IB plus on the output voltage, and simply we can remove this IB plus source from the given circuit, and the equivalent circuit will now look like this. Now here we are also assuming that the input offset voltage for the given op-amp is equal to 0 volt. That means these two terminals are at a same potential. Now if you observe over here, this non-inverting terminal is at a ground potential. So because of that, this node over here will be also at a ground potential, and because of that there will not be any flow of current through this resistor R1, and we can say that this current IB minus is flowing through this resistor RF, and because of that the output voltage Vout will be equal to minus this current IB minus multiplied by this resistance RF. So this is the error in the output voltage because of the input bias current, and this output voltage is commonly known as the output offset voltage because of this input bias current, and it is commonly denoted by a symbol VOO. So as you can see over here, this output offset voltage is proportional to the input bias current and the feedback resistance. So as the value of this feedback resistance RF increases, the error in the output voltage will also increase, and this error can be minimized by connecting the offset compensation resistor at the non-inverting terminal. So as shown in the figure, by connecting this offset compensation resistor, we can minimize the error in the output voltage. So now here, to find the total output offset voltage, we will apply the superposition theorem. So we will consider one current source at a time, and we will find the error in the output voltage because of that input bias current, and later on we will add the individual output voltages to get the total output offset voltage. So first of all, let us assume that this input bias current IB plus is acting alone and this current IB minus is equal to 0, and in that case let us find the output offset voltage. So now if you observe over here, the voltage at this node will be equal to this current IB plus times this resistance RC. Now the output voltage Vout will be the DC gain of this circuit multiplied by the voltage at this terminal, and let us say the output voltage over here is equal to output offset voltage 1. So that is equal to this V plus multiplied by this 1 plus RF divided by R1, or we can say that is equal to IB plus multiplied by this resistance RC times this 1 plus RF divided by R1. So this is the voltage that you will see at the output terminal because of this input bias current IB plus. Similarly, now let us assume that this IB minus current is acting alone and this current IB plus is equal to 0, and in that case let us say the output offset voltage is equal to VOO2, and we have already seen the value of this output offset voltage whenever this input bias current IB minus is acting alone. So we can say that the VOO2 will be equal to minus IB minus times this feedback resistance RF. So this is the output offset voltage whenever this input bias current IB minus is acting alone. So now let us combine the individual output voltages to get the final output voltage. So the total output voltage V out will be equal to this VOO1 plus VOO2, that is equal to IB plus times this resistance RC multiplied by this 1 plus RF divided by R1 plus minus IB minus times this feedback resistance RF. So this is the total output offset voltage because of this input bias currents. So now let us find the value of this resistance RC such that we can minimize the total output offset voltage. So we can write this expression as IB plus times this resistance RC multiplied by this resistance RF into R1 plus RF divided by R1 times this resistance RF. So basically here we have multiplied and the divided by this resistance RF, and the second term will remain as it is. So if you observe over here, this term is nothing but the inverse of the parallel combination of R1 and RF. So we can write this expression as IB plus times this resistance RC in RF divided by the parallel combination of R1 and RF, and the second term will remain as it is. Now if here the value of RC is the parallel combination of R1 and RF, in that case these two terms will get cancelled out and the total expression will get simplified to the IB plus minus IB minus times this resistance RF. So in this case, when RC is equal to R1 parallel RF, the expression will be get simplified to this difference between the two biasing currents multiplied by the feedback resistance RF. And if these two biasing currents are equal, in that case the total output offset voltage will become 0 volt. But if there is a mismatch between these two biasing currents, in that case we can write this total output offset voltage as the input offset current multiplied by the resistance RF, because we have seen that the output offset voltage is nothing but the difference between the two input bias currents. So this is the expression of the output offset voltage whenever the offset compensation resistor is connected at one terminal. Now, so far in our discussion, we have assumed that the input offset voltage for the given op amp is 0 volt. But if you also consider the effect of this input offset voltage, then we can find the total output offset voltage that will be present at the output terminal. So now, if you assume that all the inputs which is applied to the circuits are 0, in that case the effect of input bias currents and the input offset voltage can be represented by this circuit. So for the given circuit, the total output offset voltage will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by this resistance RF times the input offset voltage plus the input offset current times the feedback resistance RF. So basically here the first term represents the output offset voltage because of this input offset voltage, and the second term represents the output offset voltage because of this biasing currents. So this is the total output offset voltage whenever the input offset current and the input offset voltage are present at the input terminals. Now, like we have discussed in the last video, it is hard to predict the polarity of this input offset voltage and the input offset current, and because of that these two terms can be either positive or negative. But here we have assumed that these two terms are positive, and the maximum output offset voltage which will be present at the output terminal will be the summation of these individual output offset voltages. So now let us take one example, and through the example let us see how this input offset voltage and the input bias currents can affect the output voltage. So here we have been given this non-inverting op amp, and for this op amp we have been given some parameters. So basically here we have been asked to find the total output offset voltage because of the input offset voltage and the input bias currents. So first of all, let us find out the output voltage V out because of this input voltage. Now, as this circuit is connected in a non-inverting configuration, so the output voltage V out will be equal to 1 plus RF divided by this resistance R1 times the input voltage V in. Now here the gain of this circuit is equal to 10. So the total output voltage V out will be equal to 10 times the input voltage, which is equal to 10 millivolt. So the total output voltage V out will be equal to 100 millivolt. So this should be the output of the op amp if we consider all the input offset voltage and the input bias currents are 0. But because of these offset voltages and the offset currents, there will be an error in the output voltage. So now let us find out the output offset voltage because of the input offset currents and the input offset voltage. So we have already seen the expression for the output offset voltage, that is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 times the input offset voltage plus input offset current times the feedback resistance RF. Now we have derived this expression for the inverting op amp configuration, but the same expression is valid for the non-inverting configuration as well, because whenever we consider all the inputs are 0, at that time the inverting and the non-inverting configuration will be identical. So now let us put the value of this all the parameters and let us find the total output offset voltage. So if we put all the values, then we can write this expression as 10 times the 0.5 millivolt plus 15 nanoampere times this resistance RF, and that is equal to 9 kilo ohm. So we can say that the total output offset voltage will be equal to 5 millivolt plus 450 microvolt, or we can say that total output offset voltage will be equal to 5.45 millivolt. So this is the total output offset voltage because of the input bias current and the input offset voltage. So now the total voltage will be equal to this output voltage plus or minus this output offset voltage, that is equal to 100 millivolt plus or minus 5.45 millivolt. So the total output voltage can be either 105 millivolt or it can be roughly around 95 millivolt. So because of these input bias currents and the input offset voltage, there will be a 5% error in the output voltage. And moreover that, the major contributing factor in this error is the input offset voltage. And in the last video we have seen that the error which is introduced by this input offset voltage can be minimized by using the DC nulling circuits, while the error which is introduced by these input bias currents can be minimized by using the compensation resistor. So that's it for this video. I hope in this video you understood what is input offset current and what is input bias current, and how these bias currents affect the output of the op-amp, and how we can reduce the effect of these input bias currents. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.